Hey YouTube, it's Cranky B. As you can see, I got my three-wheeler apart. This frickin' tire went flat on me last night. So I just put a whole bunch of air in it now, over-inflated it a little bit. And I'm just gonna... This is just soapy water. I dump this on and look for bubbles to find the leak.
Get it close
look
up.
Look at that. That's a hell of a leak right there. That's not good. It's like a big crack in the tire too. I don't know if I can fix that. But I will try!
Right, I've got my razor blade pointing at where the crack is so it's easy to find. And to repair this tire, the first step for me is going to be to let the air pressure out of the tire. So I've got this valve stem core tool, which will allow me to remove the core of the valve stem, and the air will come out of the tire. Always want to keep this valve in a safe place. I'm just going to keep it inside the wheel here. And now that the pressure's gone out of the tire, I'm going to wipe off where the crack is a little bit and grab the awl from the tire repair kit. Find the crack in the tire. And I'm gonna go all the way up to the big size because the crack's pretty large, at least for this type of repair it is. So what you do is you this makes the hole round and it roughs up the rubber to ensure a good fit of the plug. I'm going to take a tire repair plug. It's like Daniel Jager says, sometimes it's nice when things mess up, because then you got a good subject for a video. Take one of these plugs. I'm going to put the plastic cover back over it so it doesn't dry out. Put that back in my coffee can. And you take this tool, clean out the little loop in it. I'll show you this tool up close. It's got a slot in it there. And you take this nasty, tarry, rubbery plug. And you stick it through like this until you got it halfway. You want it pretty close to halfway, at least. Now, this is a really sticky, messy job. Alright, so I've got this plug on here. It's about halfway. Now, Dad's driving around in the Dodge. Anyways, got it halfway there. Now, you take this universal cement, whatever the hell it is, open it up. It's got this brush in there. We don't need that right now. Just dip tire repair in the glue, which will lubricate it and such. Then I will come over here. I've just left the awl stuck in so I know where it is. Take some of the glue and blob it over now and take this tool with the repair in it and find the hole, jam it in there, and twist and twist and twist. Keep twisting till the tails of the repair almost get stuck in, and then pull it back out like that. Then take your razor blade and cut it off the tool like that. Cut it flush with the tire. And then I'm not gonna. I meant to get gloves, but I didn't. Oh well. Cut this flush with the tire. So you don't have those sticking out. And that is your repair. Now this is ready to go, ready to fill, and hopefully it won't leak.
So we'll test that.
If you're going to use this method to fix your tires, you really should wear gloves. And don't be stupid and make a video of it and then run out of camera memory and then forget about it, like me, because this shit's really hard to clean off your hands. And it makes a big mess. And you don't want that. So now, put the valve stem core back in like this. Tighten it down. And now I'm going to grab my tire pressure gauge, because this was a really bad leak. I had it going for half an hour and the tire was flat pretty much. What I like about these repairs is it's fast, easy, and they work. Because that really gooey, rubbery substance that's produced with the glue and the repair plug really seals up the holes, and it doesn't dry out. It stays sticky. I've got one on my snapper, which failed, but it's still gooey and sticky, so if I had done a better job, it would have stayed. Now, if you look at this, we've got absolutely no bubbles, which means it's not leaking. There's the repaired area of the tire. So basically, I just saved myself $65 in buying a tire, because it's nearly impossible to put tubes in these, because you can't get them dismounted off the rims without destroying the tire or the rim. I've tried before. It's incredibly difficult because they got this raised ridge right here, and they don't come off. Well, anyways, that's how to fix the tire. See you guys later.